Good morning students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Okay, so yesterday we have started the new concept in our chapter fraction. The concept was equivalent fraction. We have learned the concept of equivalent fraction by taking the example of chocolate. Okay, if same chocolates are there, chocolates of same size are there, and if you cut it into various equal parts and we have shaded some parts, the fractions are looking different, but their value is same. We have seen that. So equivalent fractions means what? The fraction which looks different, but their value is same. Okay. So now, how to find if any fraction is given? Suppose any one fraction is given 1/2. So how to find its equivalent fraction? That we are going to learn today. You know, we can find uncountable equivalent fraction of 1/2. We can find uncountable equivalent fraction of 1/2. But how to find it? How to find those equivalent fraction? Let's learn today. There are two ways of finding equivalent fraction. Okay, first by multiplication and another by division. Okay, so today we are going to learn to find equivalent fraction by multiplication. Now when we see, when we talk about multiplication, what we have to do to find equivalent fraction of 1/2 or any fraction, we have to multiply both the numerator and denominator by same counting number. You know, counting number we started with 1 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11, likewise. Okay, so if you multiply any this given fraction, numerator and denominator, by any counting number, suppose 5, same, but it should be same. We have to multiply both the numerator and denominator by same counting number. That is 5 and the 5 and 5 2 is 10. So 5 upon 10 is the equivalent fraction of 1/2. So in this way we can find it. Now see, the practice 5.5, which is based on this concept, finding equivalent fraction using multiplication, we are going to solve. How the questions are asked, just watch this video very carefully. This is very important, okay? And we have to use it many times frequently. Now see, write the next three equivalent fractions. Write the next three equivalent fractions of the given. See the first example, 1 upon 3, 2 upon 6, 3 upon 9. So this is the initial fraction we can say. And these two are its equivalent fractions. So in this series, according to this pattern, we have to find next three equivalent fractions. Okay. Now as I told you, to find equivalent fraction, we need to multiply both the numerator and denominator by same number. So if you observe here, to get this equivalent fraction 2 upon 6, by which counting number both numerator and denominators are multiplied? 1, you know, 2 is there, that means 1 2s are 2, 3 2s are 6, right? 2 upon 6. To obtain this 3 upon 9, it is multiplied with 3. 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9, okay? So in this series, if you want to find next 3 equivalent fractions, then what we have to do? We have to multiply it by 4. 4 1s are 4, 4 3s are 12. Okay. Then here to get this, 4 multiply by 5. 5 1s are 5, 5 3s are 15. Fine. Then here to get this, we need to multiply by next counting number, that is 6. 6 1s are 6, 6 3s are 18. So 4 upon 12, 5 upon 15, 6 upon 18 are the three equivalent fractions in this series. They are in sequence, okay? Next three, when you talk about next three, means they must be in sequence. There are, as I told you, there are uncountable, but we want next three, means they must be in sequence. This is first, second, third, fourth and fifth equivalent fraction of 1/3, okay? Now if you see the pattern here, if you see the pattern, what you can observe? If you see the numerators, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? That means it is, numerators are the, is the table of 1 1 1 1 2 1 2 1 3 3 1 4 4 5 5 1 6 6. And if you see the denominator, it is table of 3, right? 3 1 3 3 2 6 3 3 9 3 4 12 3 5 15 3 6 18, right? So this is the pattern. So isn't it easy? Yeah. See the B1, 1 upon 4, 2 upon 8, 3 upon 12. Now see numerators, 1 1 is a 1, 1 2 is a 2, 1 3 is a 3. Here, 1 4 is a 4, 1 5 is a 5, 1 6 is a 6. As we have to find next 3, they must be in sequence. So 1 3 is a 3, then 1 4 is a 4, 1 5 is a 5. Here you cannot take 1 10 is a, it will be its equivalent fraction but not in sequence. Okay. Now 4 1 is a 4, 4 2 is a 8, 4 3 is a 12. What should be here? 4 4 is a 16, 4 5 is a 20, 4 6 is a 24. Okay. Second, write the first 5 equivalent fractions. Same, here these are the first 5 equivalent fractions of 1 by 3. Just here out of 5, 3 and 2 were given, we found next. Here also we have to do same. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. So to find next 5, next means first 5 equivalent fractions of 3 upon 5. What we have to do? We have to just write the table of numerator and table of denominator. It should be in sequences. Now here 3 1 is 3 is given, 3 2 is 6, 3 3 is 9, 3 4 is 12, 3 5 is 15, 3 6 is 18. And here 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 10. So 6 upon 10, then 5 3 is 15, 9 upon 15, 5 4 is 20, 12 upon 20, 5 5 is 25, 5 6 is 30. So 18 upon 30 is equal to 3 upon 5, or 15 upon 25 is equal to 3 upon 5. If you draw two chocolates of same size, and if first chocolate if you cut into 5 parts and 3 parts are shaded, and second chocolate if you cut into 30 parts and out of 30, 18 parts are shaded, then both the shaded portion of that chocolate is same, equivalent. Okay. Next, 2 upon 3. So 2 2s are here 4, 3 2s are 6. 2 or 3s are 6, 3 3s are 9. Okay. 2 4s are 8, 3 4s are 12. 2 5s are 10, 3 5s are 15. 2 6s are 12, 3 6s are 18. Right? So in both the questions, one example is for homework. Do it today itself. Okay? Come towards the next question. Question 3, find equivalent fraction of the following. Now see how the question is given. 1 upon 8 with denominator 24. So we have to find such equivalent fraction of 1 upon 8 whose denominator is 24. As I told you previously, we can find uncountable equivalent fractions for the given fraction. Okay, so out of those uncountable, we have to find such equivalent fraction of 1 by 8 whose denominator is 24. Okay, only one we have to find. But they have given condition that its denominator must be 24. So the given fraction is 1 by 8, right? Its equivalent fraction. Why I am writing equal sign? Because the fraction, equivalent fraction which we are going to find, both will be equal in value. Okay. Its denominator is this. The number below the line must be 24. Then what will be the numerator in this equivalent fraction? Okay. So now see here, in the given fraction, denominator is 8. And in its equivalent fraction, denominator is 24. How this 24 can be obtained by multiplying it by the 8? By which number? We need to multiply 8 so that we will get 24. You know, 8, these are 24. So, since we have multiplied denominator by 3, we need to multiply numerator also by 3. Then only we will get equivalent fraction. Okay, so 3 ones are 3. So 1 upon 8 is equal to 3 upon 24. 1 out of 8 is same as 3 out of 24. Okay. Second question in this, 2 upon 5 with denominator 20. Find equivalent fraction of 2 upon 5 with denominator 20. 2 upon 5. And it's in its equivalent fraction, denominator is 20. What must be the numerator? Now see, 5, here denominator is 5. So 5 multiplied by what? 20. 5 fours are 20. So 2 fours are what? 8. Okay. 2 out of 5 is same as 8 out of 20. Understood? So two more examples are there. Example C and D in this question. You can solve by yourself. Practice by yourself. Question 4. Write an equivalent fraction of following. Same example. Same question. What is there? 4 upon 9 with numerator 20. Now they have given condition for numerator. Here they have given condition for denominator. Given fraction is 4 upon 9. And in its equivalent fraction, the numerator is 20. What must be its denominator? Now numerator will be compared with the numerator of the given fraction. Here there is 4. That means 4 multiplied by what? 20. 4 5s are 20. So what is 9 5s are? 9 5s are 45. Okay. Same here. 2 upon 5 with numerator 20. Given fraction is 2 upon 5. And in its equivalent fraction, numerator is 20. Then here numerator is 2. That means 2 multiplied by what? 20. 2 multiplied by 10. 2 tens are 20. So what is 5 tens are? 5 tens are 15. So 2 out of 5 is same as 20 out of 50. Okay. Then question number 5. Find the missing numerals. See how the various type of questions can be asked on the equivalent fraction by multiplication. Okay. First one. Find the missing digit. In that first one, 2 upon 3 is equal to dash upon 9. Means here, this question is same like this. The denominator is given 9. What is numerator of that equivalent fraction? So 2 upon 3 is equal to dash upon 9. Compare the denominator with denominator. You know, 3 multiplied by what? 9. 3 threes are 9. So what is 2 threes are? 2 threes are 6. Okay, same here. Here also denominator is given, what we have to find the numerator. So 5 multiplied by what? 25. 5 5s are 25. So what is 3 5s are? 15. Okay. Then here numerator is given and we have to find denominator. Denominator is missing. That we have to find. So 7 into what? 49. 7 7s are 49. So 10 7s are 70. Here 5 upon 12 is equal to 25 upon dash. So 5 5s are 25. So 12 5s are 60. So denominator must be 60 according to this pattern. Okay. So in this way we can find the equivalent fractions of the given fraction by multiplying both the numerator and denominator by same number. Understood? Watch this video very carefully. This concept we are going to use many times frequently. In Ganit Pravinya also, okay, same concept is there. So same lecture will be there. So I am not taking it double twice. Okay, so watch this. Solve the remaining examples in this practice 5.5. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.